18 years old and kind of wild, not yet a man, still not a child. He'd face each new day with a smile as he stumbled through his youth. Born to laugh, he'd never cry, had a wandering mind and a roving eye. He could work all day and raise hell all night, then he had to face the truth. When he said goodbye to West Virginia, he broke down and cried like a babe in mama's arms. Well, he said goodbye to West Virginia. How could he have known this was the calm before the storm? So Uncle Sam took him away, and we cuss him to this very day. He heard that big drill sergeant say, son, it's time to be a man. Your neck is red, but son, you're green. Get rid of them old blue jeans. And so began a two-year dream and the hell of Vietnam. It was goodbye to West Virginia, with a big bad moon arising in a place so far from home. Goodbye to West Virginia. Now it's not so surprising that his youthful smile is gone. Deadly silence, flash of fire. His life was hanging by a wire. What else could good old Sam require of this West Virginia boy? In his mind he saw his mom again, his baby son, and one old friend. So if this was to be the end, his heart was filled with joy. Now his name's inscribed on that black stone wall. He answered when there came the call. A reluctant hero, all in all, but a hero nonetheless. The baby son is now a man. He's touring with a five-piece band. He sings of freedom across the land, and his father's soul's at rest. 'Cause they brought him home to West Virginia, to a little Freeport graveyard near the Woodworth County line. He's back home in West Virginia, and that provides his friends and family with a little peace of mind. Well, he said goodbye to West Virginia, with a big bad moon arising in a place so far from home. He's back home in a little Freeport graveyard near the Woodford County line. Well, he said goodbye